Malaysia offers itself as a base for international halal operators. We have all the necessary elements that make for an attractive investment destination, including world-class infrastructure, advanced telecommunications and logistics network, and business-friendly policies.
Assalamualaikum and greetings everybody. I am Wardina Safiyah and you are watching Halal World, a brand new program focusing on Malaysia's halal industries. There is actually so much you want to speak about, so much you want to learn and so much you want to explore and discover with you. Halal World aims to bring Malaysia's halal industry into perspective while at the same time concentrating on the business prospects of various halal industries.
Malaysia has transformed itself from a producer of raw materials including rubber and tin into an emerging multi-sector economy. Presently, apart from palm oil, one of Malaysia's leading agricultural exports, petroleum and LNG are regarded as key mineral resources and with rising production volumes over the years has been able to boost Malaysia's export revenues. However, Malaysia is now putting an emphasis on the halal industry as it can significantly contribute to the country's economic development. Malaysia's Prime Minister, Datuk Seri Najib Tun Razak, speaks on the country's commitment in ensuring quality halal food products during the Malaysia International Halal Showcase 2010 or MIHAS 2010.
Malaysia started with the launch of MS 1900-2005 on quality management systems in 2005. Since then, we have developed the MS 1500-2009 on halal food production, handling and storage, and the MS 2300-2009 on value-based management system.
The huge potential of the halal market, believed to be more than 10 trillion ringgit annually, makes it an even more interesting market to delve into. To tap the huge halal market, Malaysia has, since 2004, taken the role of host of the International Halal Showcase, or MIHAS. MIHAS has succeeded in attracting many foreign investors, who are not only interested to ascertain cooperation, but are here to find out more on the opportunities available for new products and services.
MIHAS and the World Halal Research Summit in Kuala Lumpur represents Malaysia's efforts at showcasing a sector whose full potential has yet to be realized. Today, I am pleased to announce another milestone for Malaysia in the development of halal standards with the launching of another two new standards, namely standards on halal cosmetics, MS 2200-2008, and standards on halal logistics, MS 2400-2010.
The International Trade and Industries Ministry is tasked in positioning the country as a preferred destination for foreign investors. Here, its Minister, Datuk Seri Mustafa Muhammad, speaks on the plans that have been put in place to ensure Malaysia's aim of becoming a global halal hub is materialised.
When we talk about halal development, we're not talking about the products like food and cosmetics. We're also talking about services like banking and tourism and logistics. So Malaysia's positioning is as a nation which provides high value-added products and services in the area of halal industry. This is our strength and we believe we got the potential to develop further as we have a very sound ecosystem. We have put together policies in place in the year 2007, for example, we introduced the Halal Industry Development Master Plan, and this is the guiding policy framework with which we are advancing the Halal Industry Development Agenda in Malaysia. So we have all the ingredients to penetrate the global halal market, which is valued at more than US $2.1 trillion. We have developed over the years a very strong halal certification program, and we've been recognized as one of the world leaders in this respect. Secondly, of course, we have been developing Islamic banking finance, and today we are the leading center in the world in Islamic banking finance. Therefore, it is logical that we progress further along this route, and the development of halal industry certainly fits into Malaysia's strategy. In developing the halal industry in Malaysia, we have concentrated a number of areas. Firstly, we want to increase the level of awareness among Muslims throughout the world that it's important to get halal certification. That has been done, and we believe we've achieved some success, not only in Malaysia but also globally. Secondly, we're focusing on niche areas such as specialty, processed halal food, halal ingredients, halal cosmetics. These are areas that we're focusing on. Next, we are developing halal parks. As a matter of fact, we have developed 8 halal parks altogether in the country. The biggest is in Pulau Indah, and we have plans to develop a further 20 halal parks. The intention is to attract investors in industries to move into these halal parks. We have put in place a very liberal and generous system of incentives. For example, we are giving a 10-year income tax exemption to companies that are located in designated halal parks. We also are giving exemption on import duty and sales tax on equipment and components and machinery. So these are some of the incentives we're giving to companies which are involved in the halal industry. And by providing these incentives, we believe Malaysia has an edge over many other countries in the development of the halal industry.